your chick. I got a lot of in my mind. Light skin and dark skin, you mess me like a side. Coming with a banger, it ain't summer, but it's hot kids. I just have to drop it cause I wanna start a block.
Let's get activated. QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do.
Show me something.
That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go. When
downtown between Brush Street and I-375. That's where we're located in the heart of Detroit at Ford Field, which first opened back in 2002. Both teams emerging from the Ford Field tunnels just a short time ago. And, of course, the loudest cheers were reserved for the hometown Lions. They're set to go as they will match up with the Cincinnati Bengals. Season has hit high gear, and off we go in week 11 on EA Sports. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And they will be backed up deep. Trouble here as they're going to start this drive at the 6.
Anytime you field a kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
Carry for DeAndre Swift. And they'll get him down up past the 15.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
So a little breathing room now. First and 10 at the 17. Off play action. Mitchell. He's going to air one out for Anderson. Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off at the 33. And the Bengals are going to get the football here as they force the INT on the game's opening drive. They may have thrown the interception, obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared, but I'm with you. Okay, so didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. He'll drop this one down to Mixon. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40.
Well, they'll use him a lot out of the backfield. He had 5 catches a week ago, and he makes another catch here for good yardage.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Burrow on play action. He'll find his man, Terrace Marshall, complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a 2nd and just about a few inches here. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. Completing it to the right side, Johnson.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, Tight ends know that they become a big part in the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. A hot route, so to speak.
And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
On second down, it's Thornton. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
Rifling one complete into the hands of Marshall. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. Here to his running back. A nice run there as he picks up 6. It's going to be 3rd and goal now.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Third and goal now, mere inches from Pater. On 3rd down, Thornton, and he is in. Touchdown, Bengals. A great play there. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Bengals are going to take a first quarter lead. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0.
Bengals 7, Lions nothing. Evan McPherson to kick off.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Now a give right side Swift. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
On 3rd down, here comes Swift. And he will not get there as they stop him short right around the 34-yard line. They've now produced 3-yard gains on 3 straight plays. Leads us to 4th down. Here comes the Lions punter now as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. And he punted 3 times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. And he will be out of bounds here on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. The Bengals drive about to get going. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. I mean, look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up 2 touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
Throwing now, Burrow on first down. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down. That pass just a little bit off. It looked like maybe he tried to force it in there.
Game speed, always different, no matter what you do in practice. Can't simulate it, right? So your decision making, everything has to be a little bit quicker. Sometimes it can throw you off until you adjust.
2 yards the loss, and now 3rd and 12.
That was a terrific play, causing a loss. As a middle linebacker, simple. You can either fill holes or you can attack them, as he did there.
For the Lions, an extra DB in the game now here on 3rd down. They're passing here, Joe Burrow. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked off at the 20. And did he get in? No, they'll mark him down at the 1-yard line. Unfortunately for him, if last week was any indication, we knew a pick was coming at some point. Last week it was interception after interception, and here we go again.
We actually quit counting last week at a certain point because I thought I was going to run out of fingers, all right, because I'm not all that skilled as a mathematician. But you're right, it felt like a matter of time, and you got to think the guys on defense, they couldn't wait for this opportunity after what they saw on tape.
Back at the 2 now, here's 2nd and goal.
Check 59, Mike is 59, Mike is 59.
Swift again, and they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. The 2nd down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of 1 there.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
Swift will take this one in. It's a Lions touchdown. So the 2nd down run didn't work. They run it again on 3rd down and get in. I wasn't sure if they might pass it, Charles. We know that they like to mix it up down here around the goal line.
Yeah, almost felt like the offensive line said, forget mixing it up. Let's call our favorite running play over our best blockers, and let's get this one in.
An extra point forthcoming. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2.
Ties the game at 7. Youngway crew set to kick off.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Bengals drive about to get going. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
A couple extra tight ends in the formation here as they line up 3rd and 2. Man open, that's Ja'Marr Chase complete. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. Was that a design pass, or what was that?
It was built into the play call. He had the opportunity to either hand it inside, keep it himself to run it, or do what he just did. Throw that pass inside, hitting a receiver on the run.
On first down, it's Thornton. Room to run past midfield. And he's going to get this into enemy territory at the 45. 47 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
First down, Bengals.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Here's Burrow. Fitzgerald's got it right side. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
And Brandon, as you know, sometimes it's a lot tougher to run with these tight ends nowadays in the NFL. They're just bigger wide receivers. He lined up on the left side of the formation, ran a drag route across the field, and tried to work his way open. He was able to make the catch, but the defenders were there, couldn't do a whole lot with it afterwards.
Second down now. It's Thornton. And he's taken down inside the 30.
A big hole there. How about him handling the point of attack? Just positioning himself so that run could go right off of his backside and deep into the secondary.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up at 7. On second and 1. Burrow. And he's wrapped up. Taken down, back at the 25. Call it a loss of 5, a big sack to bring up third down. The first of their timeouts, as they'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. Burrow looking to pass. There's the stiff arm. Oh, some strong running. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7.
Well, so much for holding them to a field goal. The pressure they got home on the previous play didn't hear, and that bought their quarterback some time to find a receiver, and it sets up a first and goal.
Here we go.
They'll give it to Mixon, and he'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
Tackling's obviously critical down near the goal line. That was great work there to make the hit behind the line and make sure he doesn't get any further. Did a really nice job wrapping up and not letting him loose.
Now from the 9, here's second and goal. Now Burrow, flushed out right. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the 1. Give him 7 there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third.
Here we go.
Hill throw. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete. So it's been a long drive. They've held the ball for quite a while. Now what do you do here?
Well, to me, at this stage, after this drive, this close to the goal line, 3 points would be a letdown. I'm going for it here.
The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Is staying out there. Here we go on fourth and goal from the one. They'll try and throw for it with Burrow. That's to Chase. He's got it. Touchdown Cincinnati. Jamar Chase, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Bengals have taken the lead. Extra point by McPherson, up and good, and that makes the score 14-7. So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And with 25 seconds to go, we'll see how they want to play this. To throw is Mitchell. Throwing on first down. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets his football out shy of the 30 to the 29.
Now that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
On first and 10, Mitchell. Looking downfield for Jones. And this one is incomplete.
Well, partner, they're not content to run this one out as we head towards the half, trying to hit a big chunk play right there and add to their score.
Yeah, this is a confident group. At the very least, they're thinking field goal.
Yeah, and I don't blame them one bit. I don't think you sit on the ball going into the half when you have a chance to put some more points on the board.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now the Bengals going to signal for their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. Here's second and 10. Off the run, Mike. Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Mitchell from the gun on third down. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Jones. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
Mitchell now on first and 10. That one almost intercepted, but it's incomplete. Not a good throw there, and it'll be second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. A final shot before break. Mitchell, and he'll air this one deep for Anderson. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off inside the five. And he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this first half. So we have reached halftime here, and it's the visiting Bengals out in front. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. The Bengals set to receive. They have the lead and the football to begin quarter number three. This taken in at the goal line. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20. The Bengals drive about to get going. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. It doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker, and what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. He's got a man. That's Marshall. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Meanwhile, Burrow's throw pulled in by Marshall. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Another 13 yards there twice in a row, and they're on the move. Another first down as well. And to give this time to the tailback. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Calling no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Now it's Burrow. And he'll find Chase on the right side, complete. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions 42.
They sure put the coverage guys in a stress on that one. They thought they were going deep. Ends up curling inside for a nice chunk of yardage.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll get it down to the plate of the 37. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
That's a really nice, tough run inside. And they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
After a gain of 5, they'll wind up being about a length of the football short here on third down. Here we go. Now they go play action now. Burrow. He finds his man complete. That's Thornton. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. A big play that time on the catch and run. He had one touchdown earlier, nearly a second one there.
Yeah, it took a touchdown saving tackle to keep him out of the end zone after a big play. Perhaps you go right back to him. Don't need the distance, but maybe he can pay things off after a big effort.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. A great effort there. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bengals take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. McPherson now for the extra point. It's good, and it is now 21-7.
Makes the score Bengals 21, Lions 7.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. On the ground, it's Swift to start the drive. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Brings up second and 11 at the 13-yard line.
From the gun, Mitchell got his man complete over the middle. It's Jones, and he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Now Mitchell from the gun on third down. He'll find Jones again, complete. And he is going to have a Lions first down, and he was able to get it by plenty. A gain of 8 on 3rd and 3.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Ready? Mike 55. Hey, eat.
And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line.
And a lot of times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They'll try and run here with Swift. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. We have played three quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10. Looking to throw. Mitchell looking downfield for Jones. And a high throw there as this is knocked away down to the ground and incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game. Instead, they're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
Well, this drive, they're a perfect 2 of 2 on third down conversions, but they need a full 10 yards here. Back to throw, Mitchell. He'll drop this one off to Swift. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
Good yardage on the completion there. When they look at the scoreboard, they do understand the field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
On first and 10, it's Swift. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about...
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked up by Jesse Bates. And the Bengals are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line. And that pretty much has been the storyline, Charles. This defense, they seem to be one step ahead from the start of the game until now.
And you identified it perfectly, and we can see the frustration that's settling in now. And it's probably been there for a long time, but now it's evident because you can see it in their faces, you can see it in their body language, maybe even a little bit in that play call that ended up maybe closing them out.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Now it's Burrow. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Johnson. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
A gain of 2 brings up second and 8.
They'll keep it on the ground. Thornton.
That's what I want to see.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. He'll look to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 20-yard line.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8.
Here we go, here we go.
He was brought down at the 8-yard line. First and goal at the 8-yard line.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got it first and goal in a game that appears to have already been decided. They come with a jet sweep here as Burrow just taps that forward. And a little bit of space there, takes it inside the 5 to the 3.
Now they did get a little gain on this play, but all in all, a nice job defensively against the touch pass. They were able to string it out towards the sideline and never let him get the corner and turn it upfield for a bigger chunk of yardage.
The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal.
56-11
Looking to throw. That's to Chase. He's got it. Touchdown, Cincinnati. Jamar Chase with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Bengals look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And he doesn't even get this to the 10. He's taken down at the 9.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's going to let it fly. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 24. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. All smiles and high fives on that defensive sideline. That interception will cap off what was truly a tremendous performance.
Yeah, if you can hold a team to 7 points in the NFL, that's the kind of day that you feel really good about. Now, I do know a few guys are going to think to themselves, held them to 7 if we'd made one more play. Could have had our shutout.
He's going to fire this thing deep right sideline. And incomplete on the deep ball. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
That one looks like he'll throw here. He will find his man Chase complete. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. A big connection on that one. 30 yards. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. Trying to get it to Chase, but it's intercepted. Picked off at the 35. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. And that's a ball that he is going to want to keep, his first career interception in the National Football League.
And I love what teams do when that happens. You bring the ball to the sideline, the equipment guy grabs it, he puts a piece of tape on it, writes on it so that you know what it is, and then they tuck it away so that you can have it for later and put it on your mantle. Pretty good deal for him right there. Now he's eager to get back out on the field and get his second one.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. The Bengal pressure gets him that time. Down he goes. He'll wind up losing a full 9 yards here on the sack. Now it's third down. So this one in the win column now for the Cincinnati.